Start
right now.
Gossip.
Yeah.
411.
Yeah. And all the latest tabloid bullshit.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I got that juice. New AP. She got that juice.
I got your juicy entertainment news for Wednesday. William Shatner, a.k.a. Captain Kirk, made history this morning as the oldest person to go into space. It was pretty cool. I watched the launch. It was late. And I don't know what the delay was. I think maybe the weather, but it was so cool. He was just one of four passengers on board of Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin rockets. The trip took about 8 to 10 minutes. And the best part was when William Shatner, who, by the way, Captain Kirk, we were hoping he was going to wear like a Captain Kirk uniform, but he didn't. He had on the Blue Origins uniform. But when he emerged from the capsule after it landed, I mean, he was so emotional. It was really, really cool. He started to talk to Bezos, telling him what an incredible experience it was. Bezos wasn't really paying attention to him because everybody was like popping champagne. And so he was like, he ruined a moment for a second when Shatner was trying to like really like tell him like how awesome this was, and he was like half paying attention to him, and then he turned around and he's like, do you want some champagne? And Shatner's looking at him like, no, like I want to tell you something, like I just went into space, dude, like this is the craziest thing ever. It was really cool. They experienced about 4 minutes of weightlessness, and what I enjoyed watching was Shatner explaining how when he was going up, watching the blue sky pass him and then suddenly being in complete darkness but still being able to see the blue sky below, it was really cool. He said to Bezos, what you have given me is the most profound experience I could imagine. I am so filled with emotion about what just happened. It's extraordinary. I hope I never recover from this. I hope I maintain what I feel now. I just don't want to lose it. It's so much larger than life and larger than me. So I thought that was a pretty cool statement. Wendy Williams, she will not be able to host her show when it premieres October 18th after reportedly being hospitalized, not just for mental health reasons back in September, but she's still suffering some serious health issues and she will not be able to return to host her daytime talk show for its premiere next week, Monday. She's been diagnosed with Graves' disease. It's a thyroid condition and she's been suffering with some serious health issues as a result. But here's something. If you're a fan of the show, she's going to have a handful of guest hosts that have been chosen to take her place for the time being. And they will be announced later this week. And we'll find out who's going to be hosting for her until she's able to get back into that purple chair. And as Squid Game continues to take the world by storm and everyone is talking about it every day, Netflix just revealed that the series has reached a historic milestone. And yesterday, the Korean drama has reached 111 million viewers, making it the biggest launch for a new show on Netflix. Beating out Bridgerton. Can you believe it? Who would have thought that anyone could ever beat out Bridgerton, but it has. Bridgerton actually was holding the title at 82 million its first month, 82 million viewers. So 111 million viewers is a big jump and is pretty awesome. And if you haven't watched it yet, do yourself a favor and watch Squid Game. You'll love it. And that is your juicy entertainment news for Wednesday. Lock it in again tomorrow for more of the juice right here on the all-new Kiss 96.